Hi everyone, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to be doing a study of Frederick Leighton's Biondina. She was a very pretty young lady and the painting was done originally in 1879. But before we go into that, I'd just like to answer the query that lots of people put on my comments boxes on my videos, asking about skin colours. And to be honest with you, I keep it extremely simple. Basically, if you just mix cadmium red, ultramarine blue and yellow ochre, the three primaries, mix them together, you get a greyish colour, and that's basically what colour skin is, white skin anyway. And to modify it, you just need a little bit extra red on areas of the face that are more red, like the cheeks and the nose. The upper part of the face, the forehead and the chin are often cooler colours, whereby I mix a little bit of burnt umber in there and with some extra white. So basically it's just a matter of experimentation. The colours I use on my palette will be listed in the description box down below, so check them out and let's get going. Well, as you can see, I blocked in all the back there. You didn't see it because the camera switched off, and the reason for that was the fact that the SD card was full. I didn't notice it switch off. So anyway, it's all blocked in now. I'm going to leave that now for a few hours to dry off, and then I'll come back and carry on blocking in the skin tones. Here you see me giving the whole area of the face a thin layer of liquid original. This gives a nice moist surface for the new paint to flow on nicely. On the palette here, I've got mixed flesh tone made primarily with titanium white, yellow ochre, cadmium red, a little bit of ultramarine blue, and some burnt umber. I've got three tones mainly: light tone, medium tone, and dark tone. What you've seen me put on the face up to now is mainly the medium tone. And down, as the face goes down towards the chin, turns away from the light, as you can see, it gets a little bit darker. That's most of the dark tones and the mid-range tones done. Now you see me putting in some of the lighter tones where the light hits the face. Getting this gradation right is absolutely crucial, because the light is hitting a face from above, it hits the cheekbone, and then as a face gradually curves away from the light down to the jawline, the light gradually decreases and becomes slightly darker, but it's very, very slight, so it's important that this is correct, otherwise makes the face either look too fat or too thin. Thank you.
Thank you.
this colour I'm doing for the hair is a dark flesh tone with a little bit of burnt umber mix in and some white. Now for the lighter part, I'm just going to add a tiny little bit of white to this mixture. I'm just looking at the ear and I think that the red areas of the ear need cooling down a little bit, so I'm going to redo them with a cooler colour.
Thank you.
I need to let all that white part dry now before I put on all the detail on there. But before I do that, I've just realised that the edge of the face there needs to go slightly darker, like a dark red, where it disappears around the side, because the light's coming from hitting a head here, hitting a face on this side. So as the face curves away, where there will be less light on that edge. So that's what I'm going to try and do now, is put a darker edge there, and also the chin needs to come out a little bit more. It's a slightly wider chin. So that's what I'll do. Alright, so that will do now till tomorrow, when I'll come back and finish all this part. So there she is, Biondina. And don't forget, if you've enjoyed watching this video and you'd like to see more of my future videos, don't forget to subscribe and click on the notification bell in order that you'll be informed each time I upload a new video onto YouTube. So that's all for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.